Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your favorite brother from another mother, Brother Patrick. I'm making this direct video because I've been debating about making this video because I don't know the exact interpretation, and people will run with interpretation, and I don't know. So anyway, brothers and sisters, I had this night vision, a vision at night when I was just waking up, not a dream. Night vision, and in this night vision, what I saw a man playing a guitar, dressed in country and western clothes, and he was on the porch of an old house, country house, you know, farmhouse looking place. And then the vision switched to the American flag turned upside down, and then the vision switched to some ice cream with a cherry on top and all this, and I heard the word Sunday. I heard the word Sunday, because, you know, they call it an ice cream Sunday. Now, anybody that hears from the Lord and has dreams and visions and words from the Lord, you'll know that the Lord will do a play on words, like a wheel. You can see the wheel of a car, and then it's like the steering wheel of a car, and you see somebody, the person I'm praying with, I'll see their hands on the wheel, and they're fighting with the steering wheel. They're fighting to do their will. And then if I see the hand of the Lord, like a giant hand that would be the hand of God grabbing the steering wheel and turning it, okay, God's will be done. Like that as an example. So he's playing on the word will. In this case, Sunday, I assume the Lord is playing on the word Sunday as in the days of the week, brothers and sisters. So I asked the Lord, what does it mean? And so the Lord gave me the word meaning, but I don't know exactly what it's referring to exactly. But the first word, which I would not have gotten, was country. Because I prayed and the Lord gave me the interpretation as country. And then the upside down flag is international sign of distress. So, country in distress on Sunday was the meaning of the vision. Now, which Sunday, I don't know. I thought about, you know, the 4th of July is Saturday, and I thought about all those things that could happen with this ISIS and all this kind of stuff, possibly. So, that's why I haven't made the video, because I had this Tuesday morning, and now this is Friday, because, you know, I don't have the interpretation. But I do, here's two other things that the day before the Lord gave me another night vision when I woke up, and he showed me a newspaper headline and it said Euro, and then the second part was kind of blocked from me. I thought it said quits, Euro quits, but I couldn't quite make out the word, so I didn't make a video about that. The Lord had kind of blurred that or hidden that from me, but it was something about the Euro. It was a headline in the newspaper. Then the next morning I had that one, country in distress Sunday. So it could be related to Greece and the European thing, or it could be a great interpretation would be something to do with, you know, the America being in distress because of some kind of attacks or whatever. But the third thing, the third option that's in my mind as an interpretation, because the Lord has been showing me, if you've been watching my videos, I've mentioned several times I've had dreams, and I even had a dream on Monday night. I've had lots of dreams and vision this week. Because we've been, Brother Gary and I have been praying for that. The Lord would give us visions and dreams and understanding of what's about to happen. And so, that's Bear 049. So anyway, on my dream on Monday night, I dreamed I have a friend who's secret, you know, who's gay, but he claims to be a Christian. A guy I grew up with. This is my neighbor down the street from me. And so in my dream, we were separated. There was a big, tidal wave. We were washed out to sea in a car, and I escaped, and he didn't want to escape. He wanted to stay in the ocean. So I had that Monday night also, and then the next day was the gay marriage decision, or it was whatever day. It was the night before the gay marriage decision thing. So that could all be interrelated. The Lord has shown me about pastors coming to me, and I'm just tying all this together, what I think the meaning is. I had different pastors that I know coming to me and grabbing me and saying, Pastor Patrick, can you please come to my church? My church is in civil war. All these pastors. And so Sunday could refer to church, even though it was country in distress on Sunday. You know, it could be, which is not as bad as the first interpretation of some kind of like ISIS thing or whatever, some kind of attacks in America on Sunday, or a Sunday, this Sunday or next Sunday or whatever, a Sunday, would be, you know, distress in the church on Sundays with this, you know, trying to force churches to do gay marriage and a civil war in the church and you know, eventually that the persecution of people who refuse to do gay marriage is churches that refuse to, you know, allow gay couples to join the church and all this kind of stuff. Of course, that's coming if the church is still here, you know, if the rapture hasn't happened and the people who will be raptured are still here. You know, we're going to see that, those people who would be raptured. Now, I just want to say this, too, on the end of this video. I want to cut this off. People talk about, okay, we know that there's the bride of Christ and there's the church. But I want to say this because I always have someone asking me about this because of all these people on YouTube making videos who are not preachers. The true church is the bride. There is Christendom. There are those churches that are filled with people. Or every church has people in it who are tares and not wheat, weeds and not wheat, people who are not even born again. But all truly born again followers of Jesus Christ are part of the real church, the church invisible, the church universal, not one denomination, Old Baptist or whatever, Assemblies of God or whatever. The church is the true body of Christ, which is hidden all over the world, and they're in different denominations, and some people don't even go to any church, and they're followers of Jesus Christ. That's the church. When people talk about the church, they're talking about Christendom, which is greater Christendom, people who use the name of Christ, but they're not even saved, which is many of the old mainline Protestant denominations and to the liberal ends from there. You know, all whatever groups you want to talk about who try to use Jesus. Like the Mormons and stuff, they say, oh, we're followers of Jesus Christ, but they have a whole different gospel and all that. So that's part of greater Christendom and what people would refer to as the church. But the church of Christ, Jesus, the real church of Jesus Christ, the true body of Christ is the bride. People who are, and it's invisible and they're spread out. You know, there's wheat in all of the fields, and then there's weeds, brothers and sisters. And it seems as if the weeds are much more than the wheat, which is true. And I believe, just in my idea, the way God does in patterns, it'll be a tithe. You know, a tenth of what we know as supposed Christians will be the real church, the bride. You know, that's just my speculation based off the way God does things in patterns, brothers and sisters. Anyway, God bless you guys. And so I hope it's the latter as opposed to the country of the United States as a nation in distress versus in the church. And then also, of course, this thing with Greece and all that, if the euro collapses, I'm assuming they're not going to let it happen. But who knows? The Lord only knows. If the euro collapses and all that, of course, that would be major distress, and that would lead into, of course, a collapse of the world economy, which would be, you know, and we're still here. It's not going to be a pretty sight. There are going to be all kinds of bad things going on. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. I want to load this. I want to get this out. God bless you guys.